Welcome to Inside the Taubman Approach podcast. I'm your host, Benjamin Harding. This new podcast is an inside look at the power of the Taubman Approach, an approach to working with playing-related problems such as discomfort, tension, pain, and injuries. Through firsthand experiences and discussions with some of the premier teachers of this approach, we'll be sharing how pianists at various stages of learning the piano have benefited and grown through applying the Taubman approach. Sponsored by the Golandsky Institute. The Golandsky Institute is on a mission to provide cutting-edge instruction to pianists based on the groundbreaking work of Dorothy Taubman. If you're interested in learning more about the Taubman approach, be sure to check out the show notes of this episode and follow links to sign up for our newsletter, to stay up to date with all that the Institute offers, including their premier subscription service that allows you to take lessons on the Taubman approach from anywhere. Let's get into today's episode. Okay, so today's episode is a little different. I've been asked to share why are we doing Inside the Taubman Approach as a podcast, and to describe a little bit about my personal journey with the Taubman Approach and why I'm just so passionate about getting the word out about the Taubman Approach as it is taught at the Golandsky Institute. So buckle in for a little bit. I'm just going to kind of give you our reason why we're doing Inside the Taubman Approach and maybe the vision for what is possible with this podcast as you, dear listener, share it with your friends, family, even enemies. You should share this with everybody because the Taubman Approach is for everyone. Everyone, and that's what I want to kind of highlight today. I want to highlight the fact that the Taubman Approach is for anybody who wants to play in a free way, in an expressive way, in a pain-free way. The Taubman Approach is for you if you want to go deeper as an artist, if you want to play the piano and learn the piano in a positive environment, in an environment that really encourages you to be your best self. The Taubman Approach is for you. So let's dive in. And so let's ask the question, why am I, Benjamin, so personally passionate about the Inside the Taubman Approach podcast? Well, it's because I want to get the word out. I want to get the word out about the Golandsky Institute. I want to get the word out about this life-changing work as brought to us and mastered for us by Edna Golandsky. I want to bring this knowledge, this approach, this comprehensive approach to you, to your friends, to your family. I believe that this is an approach that will change your life if you're a pianist. Whether you're a child, whether you're an adult learner, whether you're a seasoned professional artist, you will be changed as you dive into the Taubman Approach. I talked to one of my friends just recently about the Taubman Approach in the 80s. That's the 1980s. For those of you who are younger listeners, that may seem a long time ago, but believe me, it's not that long ago. But anyway, my friend, my dear friend, went to Dorothy Taubman and to Edna Golandsky to study this amazing work. And he would remark that, and he did indeed remark, he noticed that it was like a who's who of pianists going in and out of either Edna's studio or Dorothy's studio in studying this work. And I've seen this recorded, I believe, actually in the New York Times, that Dorothy Taubman and Edna Golandsky are like the underground piano teachers. That conservatory pianists would go to them to solve key problems. And as I interview people for this podcast, Inside the Taubman Approach, I'm hearing that from them. I'm hearing that from them. And you've heard it from them, where they've experienced something that is a challenge to them in their playing, whether they're just not playing a passage freely enough, or they're absolutely injured. So on the extreme side, absolutely injured. And they need help. And what do the conservatory teachers do? But they recognize that Edna Golandsky and the Golandsky Institute is the premier organization to help them solve those problems, to help them play in a free way, and or be healed from injury. It's incredible how much this is a reality in this work. The same friend that told me about the Taubman Institute in the 1980s said that oftentimes this institute would be like a evangelistic healing service where people would come with different problems and play, and Dorothy Taubman and Edna would basically heal them on the spot. And there would be tears and there would be celebration. It was like nirvana, you know? And here is this work continuing to have that same kind of power over people's piano playing than it did back then. In fact, it's even more impactful than it was back in the 1980s. It's even more vibrant. It's even more supportive. It's so exciting for me. And you can tell that I'm passionate about this. It's so exciting for me to get on a call with somebody in Australia, Switzerland, Germany, Canada. And that's just so far in the podcast, friends. And where I hear the same kind of revolutionary change that happens in a person's playing. And therefore, because you know this, the piano is so close to our hearts and minds. It's ingrained in our bodies, and therefore it's ingrained in our psychology. And so when we experience freedom in the piano, this affects us holistically. We begin to see that there's hope, that there's a path forward for the piano playing that we absolutely love. And for some of us, we feel that it's an absolute calling. We're put on this earth to play the piano, to teach the piano, to enjoy the piano. Some of us feel that it's like a spiritual calling. I know I do. And so when some of us are up against sort of physical limitations, whether that be absolute pain and crippling pain that just inhibits playing the piano at all, and even inhibit daily life skills, okay? Or it's just giving us freedom in a passage that we never thought we could ever play. This approach gives hope. So that's why I'm passionate about Inside the Taubman Approach, because I want to get the word out to everyone, to everyone. I want you to think about this. And I was reflecting on this on a run, just a couple of days ago, actually. I was thinking about revolutions. I was thinking about scientific revolutions. I was thinking about paradigm shifts in the history of Western society, in the history of Eastern society, in the history of global history, a global phenomenon of revolutionary change, okay? I was thinking of the idea that modern piano technique is really only about 200 years old. It's, the modern piano is about 200 years old in terms of its construction, the parts, the double escapement mechanism for the grand piano. And when the piano began to really take shape in the Industrial Revolution, there were all kinds of piano methods that came about. And largely, they were based upon harpsichord technique. So just think about this for a minute. 200 years of piano technique being developed. And it starts out with the harpsichord, sort of this isolation of fingers, keeping your hand still. And you can see this in the early literature of these piano methods, keeping your hand still, people inventing contraptions like that rod and glove thing. Do you remember that? Like that's at the beginning of the 19th century where they had this rod that would attach from the cheek blocks of the piano and there would be a rod there and you'd have a glove that would go horizontal to the keys and you would take your hand and put it in this glove. It's absolutely horrific to think about. But this was sort of how people were envisioning the piano method at the beginning of the nation stages of piano methods. It was largely based on isolation. And here comes Chopin. Chopin began to explore possibilities as it related to the piano. We can see in his etudes, of course, certain elements of modern piano technique that he was beginning to think about. And that was absolutely revolutionary. Some of my friends, actually not some of my friends. I think in the latest, I'm trying to think about where this came from in my brain. It's Alan Walker's latest biography of Chopin, where he describes that Chopin began to write down a piano method that was based upon sort of the natural tendency of the hand to go on the keys. And you've probably heard of this, you know, putting your hand on E natural, F sharp, G sharp, A sharp, and then C natural, sort of as a guide to those shorter and longer fingers, right? And Chopin recognized that, but unfortunately, that piano method is largely lost, especially the more comprehensive technique that Chopin was envisioning. But then you go forward, okay? Let's just fast forward for the sake of argument to Dorothy Taubman. Okay, so let's just say that for the last 50 years, and that's conservative, that's a conservative estimation, all right? Let's say just for the last 50 years that the Taubman approach has been on the scene, okay? 50 years, that's a quarter of modern piano technique. In the history of the world, 200 years is not a long time. And again, that is a very conservative estimate to say, wow, the Taubman approach has been around for 50 years. My goodness. That is certainly a conservative number, but I'll tell you that for Edna Golandsky, Edna has been around this work for 40 years at least. At least 40 to 50 years of working closely with Dorothy Taubman and then developing this revolutionary method to bring it about in this current state. Just think about this in terms of piano technique as it exists over the last 200 years. Here comes the Taubman approach for the last 50 years, has been taught, has been in a way mastered, although she would never say this, Edna has mastered this approach, and where students have been studying with her for 40 years, And the level of depth of this body of knowledge is just inspiring. It's just inspiring. So why am I passionate about Inside the Taubman Approach? Because it's a real revolution in piano technique. And when you think about it, in the life cycle of methods and of piano technique, it's about time that this approach gets into the mainstream of piano teaching and of piano learning. It's about time. When you think about different scientific and historical revolutions, this is coming at a time where the body of knowledge for piano technique and piano method has reached a place of, let's say, critical mass and exploding on the scene. Exploding on the scene is the Taubman approach. Is the Taubman approach. Because it is a comprehensive method. Here's what I want to say with this. As I've interviewed people for Inside the Taubman Approach, they can bring any question to their certified teacher, to their master teacher. They can bring any question, and the question will be analyzed to see first if it's the right question, and then second, to provide a solution to that right question. Okay? This in and of itself is a revolutionary idea as it pertains to piano methods. Because what have we been told at different points in our lives? And this is no slighting of, for example, my amazing teachers that I've had all the way through my life. I've had incredible teachers, and they have poured their very lives into me, okay? This is not a slight on them at all. But this is common in the piano world. This is common in the field of teaching piano, where somebody will say, just practice that slowly, speed it up, practice it slowly again with different rhythms, and it will gradually become part of your hand. Okay? And maybe there's a little bit of guidance in terms of rotation and, okay, how we're sort of landing on certain key areas. But if you're like me, you get into performance, can you really count on the fact that you've played it 2,000 times? I get really wigged out in performance to say, oh my goodness, I've played this 1,000,001 times, but I still feel insecure about that passage. And again, that is not a slight on any of the teaching that I've received. But what if there was a way to approach that passage that made it feel like I was absolutely confident that I could perform this on stage? What would it look like to have a method that would break down the movements into little steps for me to think through, for me to approach not only that passage, but other passages? What would it look like? And friends, I got to say, it looks like the Taubman approach. There hasn't been a question that I have brought to Edna that hasn't been answered. And this is the story of the Taubman approach and inside the Taubman approach. As I interview people that have been involved with the work for 40, 50 years, or have just come to it like myself, this is the story, the legacy of the Taubman approach and Edna Golandsky. This is the legacy that you can bring a question, any question as it pertains to piano technique, musicianship, musicality, the piano, and it will be analyzed first. That question is going to be looked at to say, is this the right question or is there a better way to sort of ask this question? And then to say, okay, now that we've refined the question to really get at the heart of the issue, how do we begin to solve it? And the solution is always there. It's always there with this approach. So, yeah, why am I personally passionate about the Inside the Taubman Approach podcast? Is because I want to get the word out to as many people as I can that there is hope for you to play in a confident and free way. And there is hope if you have an injury or you have some kind of pain and you're like, how am I going to overcome this? There is hope for you. There's hope for you, dear listener. Go to GolandskyInstitute.org, sign up for our newsletter, sign up for resources that we have there on the website, and let's be in touch because we can get you the right kind of training, whether that's in person or online. There's also a subscription service for you at GolandskyInstitute.org, and we can provide the best possible training in this work for you. And it gives people hope. So for me, I want to go into the Taubman approach. And I have, let me sort of outline my journey a little bit. So there's a backstory here. When I was a doctoral student, my dear teacher told me about the Taubman approach. And he began to show me the different videos as I was studying different ways of teaching in piano pedagogy. And he showed me different kinds of rotational movements and the videos of Dorothy Taubman to play that scale, that beginning process of really freeing up your forearm and really working on that specific timing that single and double rotation needs. So he showed me those wonderful videos. Choreography of the hands come to mind. They're on YouTube, of course, at GolandskyInstitute.org. Our YouTube channel has choreography of the hands there. And so he began to show me this work. I have to say, though, that when I was in Philadelphia studying, I heard of the Taubman approach, but it was presented in a negative way. It was presented in a way that, oh, yeah, that's just rotation. And, well, of course, you know, everybody does rotation. That was sort of a naive understanding that's out there in terms of what the Taubman approach brings in terms of a comprehensive piano approach. All that to say is that's another reason why I'm really passionate about Inside the Taubman approach, is because I want to correct sort of maybe public perception that's out there as it relates to the Taubman approach in terms of what it's absolutely able to do. Okay. So yeah, I heard about the Taubman approach maybe as a as an undergrad in Philadelphia, that it was told to me sort of in a negative light. But when I went to the doctoral work, it was told to me in a positive light. And I was really began to be fascinated by it. And then fast forward, I was having a meal at a summer camp that I teach at with one of my dear friends, Dr. Michael Landrum. And Michael was helping a student with brittle bone disease. Okay. So he was confined to a wheelchair. And Michael was adamant, absolutely adamant, to bring his wheelchair to the appropriate height so that his arm and hand were able to be brought to the keyboard in an aligned way. And I began to talk to Michael. Michael, how did you think through all this? And he began to share with me about Dorothy Taubman and Edna Golandsky. And I thought to myself, my goodness, this is amazing. This is amazing. And Michael literally built for this young man a platform for the wheelchair to come on the platform so that he could play the piano with freedom. And he could enjoy playing the piano. How awesome is that? And so fast forward even more, I kind of put that in the back of my mind, right? And I started a podcast called Piano Explored. Some of you have listened to that podcast. I started that podcast to sort of explore the piano, and I've been a lifetime learner of the piano, and Edna Golandsky's publicist reached out to me to see if I'd be interested in having Edna Golandsky on the podcast. And I was like, of course. I'm amazed that she would be interested in coming on this little fledgling podcast called Piano Explored. And so she came on the podcast and we hit it off. I could just resonate with so much of the story that she was telling me as it related to the Taubman approach. I just resonated with it. And I thought to myself, I've got to give this approach a shot. It's really affected my friend Michael. It's had a positive impact on my doctoral teacher, Mr. Bradford Gowan. It's really impacted, obviously, Edna and her institute. And I went to the GolandskyInstitute.org and just saw the level of pianist that was surrounding this institute. I saw classmates of mine from Manhattan School of Music engaged in this institute and loving this institute, pianists that I absolutely love and respect, and am just in awe of their artistry. And I thought, my goodness, I want to be a part of this. And so I reached out to Edna and I said, would you consider teaching me this amazing approach? And we were texting back and forth, and it ended up that I could study with Edna. And then fast forward a little bit more is to say, I wanted to do something for this amazing work. I wanted to get the word out that this approach can change your life. And look, friends, I'm a total beginner when it comes to the Taubman approach. I am working right now on single and double rotation, and I'm taking my time with it. Of course, I have some concerts that I'm working towards, but you know, so the work doesn't stop for me and the practicing doesn't stop for me. But already I am beginning to see some change in the way I practice and in the way I approach the piano. Not only that, but I've gotten the Taubman technique tapes, and I'm devouring these tapes and this approach. It's phenomenal, friends. I am loving every single second. I've never been injured at the piano. I was injured, however, in playing the viola. that's a long story, maybe for another time. I had a pinched nerve on my second finger as I played the viola. Anyhow, got that solved. It feels just a little tingly to this day. But anyhow, I have never been injured in playing the piano. I've had a little bit of shoulder pain, a little bit of neck pain, some headaches if I practice for long periods of time. But I've always felt like there are limitations in my playing. And my teachers would testify to this, and my colleagues would testify to this, that there are some limitations to my piano playing. And I'm absolutely a nervous wreck when I go on stage. Absolutely a nervous wreck. But what I'm finding is that if I can trust my body and how I think about the movements as it relates to the Taubman approach and as it relates to passages on the piano, I'm becoming more and more confident as I dive into this approach. So I've been studying the Taubman approach, boy, couple months maybe, you know, in a serious fashion and every other week fashion with Edna Golandsky, and I am loving it. And not more than that, but yeah, maybe more than that, I am just so inspired by the stories that people are telling to me on Inside the Taubman Approach. And I want to share those stories with you. I want to get the word out about this work because it is life-changing. And so I want to challenge you now, dear listener. I want to challenge you. I want you to test the Taubman approach as it is taught at the Golandsky Institute. That's important, okay? Because here's the thing. There are many folks that have dabbled in the Taubman approach. And unfortunately, you know, the word has gotten out that it's just about rotation and it's just about this, it's just about that. No, friends, it is comprehensive. It is absolutely comprehensive and can change the way you think and play the piano and feel physically at the piano. I can't say more. I could say more, but Let's just leave it at that to say that it's life-changing. It's totally life-changing. It's comprehensive. It gets into all of the crevices of your soul and mind in terms of how to play the piano. It's exciting because it's going to give you freedom. So here's my action step for you. Here's my challenge to you. Test it. Test it. I'm testing it right now. Because I've been encouraged to test it. I've been encouraged to ask the tough questions about the repertoire. I've been encouraged to bring problems to my lessons. I've been encouraged to dive deep. So I want to challenge you, if you're listening to this at this podcast, and I've kind of rambled on here a little bit, but to say, I want you to test the Taubman approach. I want you to get in touch with the Golandsky Institute. I want you to begin to test it and see how deep you can go, because it's really fathomless in terms of the depth that you can experience in studying this approach. There's a symposium coming up, okay? There's a symposium coming up this summer. It's going to be online. You should totally do it, okay? Go to GolandskyInstitute.org, sign up, and just watch this approach at work. You're going to see the approach being tested over and over and over again in engaging ways, in fun ways, in exciting ways. You should come to the Golandsky Institute Symposium that's coming this summer. Okay, so that's a little bit about why I'm so passionate about Inside the Taubman Approach. And I want to invite you to share this episode, share the other episodes that we've produced thus far. We're just getting started. I've got so many interviews coming up that have already been recorded that we're going to be releasing over the next couple of weeks. And we have so many interviews to get to through the Golandsky Institute and the benefits that people have experienced with the Taubman Approach. I want to thank you so much for listening and listening to my ramblings of my story, so to speak. I've just got a notebook here with some ideas, and I just kind of, what do they say? Freestyled this episode. And I hope it's been an encouragement to you. Be in touch with us, and thanks so much for listening.